guest has got himself into a right old 2-8, Philip, hasn't he?
Yes.
He has. He's not over his old mum's bread and honey, but also his new pot and pan.
Avaganda.
That's terrible.
So we're back in the black then? Oh, clever boy. I don't know what we'd do without you.
That investment you were talking about, I want in.
This is supposed to be the happiest day of our lives.
He can't know that I gave you that money.
There is no return. The deal went bust.
You are now joined in legal partnership.
You've got 4 months of mortgage arrears.
Oi, what are you doing?
I need to ask you all to leave.
What are they doing here, Thumwar? What have you done?
And Thumwar is going to get the blame.
Yeah.
You just stood there. You just stood there and said nothing.
Saeed lets him take the flak a little bit. It's sort of understandable. He's watching his back, isn't he? He's been in trouble with the family before. He's stolen.
I love the fact that when you two are watching it then, you're saying, well, what happens then? Oh, no.
No, don't tell me.
He's a rubbish businessman, isn't he?
Yeah, he's awful. I mean, I don't know how the writers came up with the idea of a £10,000 worth of cleaning products that he decided to shift without having a market ready for it. But,
it's a challenge.
Yeah, that was the beginning of the... the decline of Saeed.
Well, it's fascinating because, I mean, there are lots of firsts in soaps, and this is actually the first ever soap character to have a civil partnership. I don't think that's been done before.
Oh, really?
We were looking back. I mean, you correct us, and I'm sure you will if we're wrong, but I think that's actually the case.
Yeah, and they did say I do, and we got through that bit. It was just afterwards that it all sort of went a bit pear-shaped.
There was one moment, I thought, which was... for me, it showed how far the relationship within the family had moved on, and that was Masu. When Danny and you were caught,
yes.
Masu caught you, and you were saying, no, 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 and then the camera whitens and he says no in the background. It was an issue about... relationships, but not an issue about homosexuality.
Yeah, yeah, and I think that's been really important. I think throughout the last 3 years, because obviously it's been a 3.5-year build to then getting married or a civil partnership, but I think there has been a huge shift. But then I think when we started the story, we were surprised by how accepting the audience was and how ready they were to see something like that. So I think it's been... brilliant.
Well, you were expecting something of a backlash, weren't you? Which never, thankfully,
yeah.
never came.
Never came, no. I think we, I don't think we judged the audience response well enough. I don't think we gave enough credit to the audience.
Yeah.
What kind of reaction did you get as you're out and about and people
great.
Talking to you, people writing to you?
Yeah, yeah, all positive. Never been any negative. Comments anything. It's been
so
brilliant.
So this mix now that we've got, this issue with Danny, who I feel maybe hasn't gone away completely.
No, he hasn't. He returns to... well, he can't be punched in the face in the argy-bargy and leave without his dignity. He's got to come back and take some sort of revenge, and he does.
So how dark... I know you can't tell us too much, but it's kind of how dark does this get?
Well, he's left, so they can't fire him.
Well...
yeah, but can you go back?
Potentially.
Yes.
Maybe they have... well, they... well, I don't know how much I can reveal, whether or not I go under a black cab or go in a black cab.
We wouldn't want you to spoil it for anyone who's watching. So,
no,
so
exactly.
just point us roughly in the right direction.
Gary Lisa comes back and Christian becomes embroiled in a storyline with him, which involves the police and possible arrests.
So financial issues?
Not necessarily financial.
Oh, okay. Well, let's not go any further than that.
I thought maybe you were going to get together. Romance.
Well,
maybe.
You never know. Ooh. Triangle.
We've got a.
We've happened to them before.
We've got a clip from tonight's show, and Saeed and Christian argue about how they are going to get out of this financial mess.
You knew this was coming.
Look, we go away.
You must have known about it for days, weeks, even.
Our honeymoon, Christian. It's what you want. It's what you've planned and organised and spent the past God knows how long going on about.
You are.
And when we get back.
Going on.
When we get back and the dust has settled, I will explain it then.
You mean when the argy-bargy's boarded up? And Tam's taken it in the neck? And your parents, well, they can't even pay the mortgage on their house?
We'll work it out then.
No.
Look, Christian, this is my family.
Yeah, well, they're mine now.
Look, I am not running this past you. We have booked a holiday. It is non-refundable. We go on our honeymoon now.
Oh, grow up, Saeed!
How long were you in that wedding suit for?
3 weeks. It was a long shoot. It never seemed to end. So, yeah, it was a long time. Well, that block, the 4 episodes, because it was quite a big block,
yeah.
We were assigned, yeah, just under 3 weeks to shoot it all. So I was never out that suit. It was a little bit stinky by the time we
had finished. And what about your last day? What was your last day like?
It was great. It was, yeah, I had a knees up. But then it didn't last long because I anticipated, having left the show, I could have a bit of a rest, but I left on the Friday and then I started a new job on the Monday, so...
Yes, so what's your new job?
I'm doing a play in London town at the Trafalgar Studios in Studio 2, and it's called Tape. And it's a three-hander set in an American motel room, and I couldn't get any more different from Saeed. hence Tramp Chic, actually. This is not... this isn't my personal
nice,
taste. This is just sort of here for the show. But, yeah, I'm in it with two other actors. It's just a three-hander. It's a very intense, sort of, darkly comical thriller. Oh, he's a drug-dealing dropout who has an agenda. He sort of gets these three characters, the other two actors, Darren Bransford and Kate Lestow, he gets, who are brilliant in the show. The three of us get together in a motel room. It's all set up by my character, Vince, because he wants to explore and confront an issue that has been haunting him for 10 years regarding their last day of senior year at high school.
Oh, goes right. Did you actively go looking for theatre work? Was this something you wanted to
do? I really wanted to get
change
back
and get
on
back
the stage.
To theatre.
Yeah, absolutely. Partly because I wanted to terrify myself. And this was a big challenge. My character doesn't leave the stage, so...
And you just, for quite a long time, just wear boxer shorts, don't you?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm coming. Where's it on again?
So that's a... that in itself is, you know, something
a challenge.
Of a worry.
Yeah, well, the audience is where you are, so...
Well, lovely. Also, you say
yeah, they could tug them down if they wanted to.
Well, you're so close that you step on members of the audience.
I have trod on a few people, and there's a big fight scene that, yeah, I think I've rolled on people's legs, but they should learn to tuck them in, you know?
Yeah,
you've got a rolling around fight scene and you're just wearing boxer shorts.
I think I may have put on a pair of jeans by then.
Right, okay, well, I was going to say, because
yeah.
That's just, you know...
Nothing's hanging
no
out.
No one needs that.
Oh, disappoint me.
Once you've done that, I assume that because we know that time on any continuing drama is like a factory, because you really are working non-stop, you went straight from your last day, straight into the theatre. Do you get a holiday, get a break, or are you going to pick something else now?
Hopefully. Well, I'm hoping that because this show runs... It runs until November the 10th, so I think yeah, that's another 4 weeks, I think, we've got left. And then after that, I'm hoping that I might get a little bit of a break. But if work comes up, I think I've got to take it at this stage. Cause...
Ball to turn it down,
yeah,
that's for sure.
Exactly.
Thank you for coming in today.
Thank you very much.
I reckon I'll be back in EastEnders before you know it. That's my...
Setting up
that's
home
my
with Gary
theory.
Lucy.
Yeah. In the penthouse.
Yeah.
That penthouse he's always talking about.
Watch this face.
Thank
yeah,
you, Mark.
Absolutely. Well, great also, another continuing drama. Well done to Emmerdale on their brilliant live episode last night. That was really... Did you watch that?
No, I've got it taped.
Oh,
it
was really good. I mean, of course, it's a little bit like... I mean, you do watch to see if anybody does any sort of stumbles or trips or whatever, and they were really tiny, so it was way too slick.
Well, they were so nervous, weren't they, because we've been seeing the build-up for weeks now and all the interviews.
But it was really complicated as well. I mean, do you think there's a huge great setup going over here and a huge great setup over here? We've got two bursts going
on. And did it rain?
On
because they were really worried
no
about
the weather
rain.
Looked all right. It actually all right. Didn't look too bad.